We're here in the museum's botany collection, which we call a herbarium, to tell you about a recent discovery of a new genus of plant that was hidden for 150 years, Tabecia. This genus is actually a bamboo, and the genus was discovered not in the field like a lot of plant species. It was found actually in museum collections. As we were working on a separate question, we found three different species that didn't fit. So we began to investigate those even further, and they became actually a group unto themselves. Discovery of new species happens relatively routinely, but a new genus is a major scientific find. All of life is organized into a hierarchy. The ranks of that hierarchy go kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. A genus is really just a name for a group of plants that are closely related to each other. It's a bit like a last name. So a group of people share a last name, even though they have their own individual names. Tabecia has three species in it, and each of those three species was known before. They were just classified in a different genus named Arthrostylidium. One of the most straightforward ways to tell them apart is to look at the anatomy of their leaves. So we actually have to make microscopic cross-sections of their leaves and look for differences in how the cells are arranged inside the leaves. The new genus grows in the West Indies, on the islands of Cuba, Hispaniola, Puerto Rico, the Virgin Islands, Bahamas, and Turks and Caicos. And the species in this new genus are all very small. They're less than 1 centimeter in diameter of their main stems, and they grow in drier areas. So they're still in forests. They grow on special soil that has a special geologic origin called serpentine soil. The West Indies are a biodiversity hotspot, which means adding a new genus is actually important to conservation in the region. I think one thing that's neat about MPM is that real research is happening all the time here, and discoveries are made just like the one I'm describing today. And these discoveries will eventually end up in our exhibits. So when people come to MPM today, they're seeing exhibits from discoveries that were made 5 years ago, 10 years ago, maybe even longer. And hopefully one day, Tabecia will be in an exhibit in the future.